Everybody, it's Maria. Welcome back to the channel. How's it going? We are continuing Miley Cyrus's Younger Now album with the lead single. I know that because the device just told me this, Malibu, which I should have known this, but I thought the title track was the lead single. I think it was like the second single. Let me look at my Google real quick. Singles off of Younger Now by Miley Cyrus. Just for yucks. Are these the singles? No. These are... I was trying to see if, I could find something that would show me the singles. Wikipedia usually does, but I don't know. Okay. According to Wikipedia, you can trust it or not trust it, that's up to you. The two singles off of the album was Malibu and Younger Now. Which, honestly, I would have thought that either Rainbow Land or Thinking or Bad Mood, one of those would have been a third and final single, but that's just my opinion. Well, that's not surprising. Real quick, I'm just reading this real quick. Younger Now received mixed reviews from music critics who felt that the songwriting and production lacked substance. It debuted at number 5 on the U.S. Billboard 200. Malibu and Younger Now were released as the singles and the former track certified double platinum by the RIAA, peaking at number 10 at the Billboard 100. Which that means, I mean, it's not bangers era, but it actually did better than I thought it did. But it really is, God, it's a mixed bag, and I can't wait to talk about the album in general when I go to do the review. To those rockers out there, yes, I did get the Evolution review out for Patreon. I left a link in the playlist description, so check it out whenever you guys have a chance. Patreon.com/MariaOrdino. That is the same place where you will find the Younger Now review. So with all that said and done, let's sing the lead single, Malibu. Here we go. I never came to the beach or stood by the ocean. I never sat by the shore under the sun with my feet in the sand, but you brought me here, and I'm happy that you did, 'cause now I'm as free as birds catching the wind. I always thought I would sing, so I never swam. I never went boating, don't get how they were floating. Somehow I get so scared of what I can't understand. But here I am, next to you. The sky is more blue in Malibu. Next to you in Malibu. Next to you. We watch the sun go down as we're walking. I'd spend the rest of my life just standing here talking. You would explain the current and I'd just smile, hoping I'll just stay the same. Nothing will change and it'll be us just for a while. Do we even exist? That's when I make a wish to swim away with the fish. It's supposed to be this hot all summer long. I never would have believed you 3 years ago. You would tell me I'd be here writing this song. But here I am, next to you. The sky's more blue in Malibu. Oh, next to you in Malibu. Oh, next to you. It's a brand new start, dream come true in Malibu. Find it real quick since I'm, oh crap, I need to go find another playlist. Fuck. Because they didn't include Rainbow Land, which is the next track. Alright guys, there you have it, Malibu. What can I say about this song that wasn't already said? I can see why it was the lead single. But Miley is just something else, because I mean this in the most respectful way possible, because like after Can't Be Tamed, or maybe after, you know, maybe after the Time of Our Lives LP. No, I'm gonna say after Can't Be Tamed. After Can't Be Tamed, she's changed genres every freaking album, dude. Younger Now, she went back to her roots with the country pop twist. She Is Coming, I think it went... Wait, no, I forgot about Dead Pets. Shit. Bangers, hip-hop, you know, mixed with pop. Dead Pets was more experimental. I couldn't even tell you what genre I would put it in. It was just, you know, experimental type stuff. What came after Dead Pets? I would like to say it was Younger Now, but I'd be a liar. I think it was. Then she went back to her roots with this, and then after that, she went back towards more the, I don't want to say hip-hop, but kinda? But She Is Coming. And then, after She Is Coming, she went towards more of a rock, like, 80s rock, glam rock sound, like Blondie and things like the Cranberries and Joan Jett and the Blackhearts, you know, that kind of stuff, you know, with Billy Idol, all that stuff. And then she went towards her pop with Endless Summer Vacation, but I wouldn't be surprised if there's like, I would say it has like, it's like a disco pop record. So my look, she with the next album, she probably I wouldn't be surprised if she went full-blown country with the next one, or, I don't know, she always changes genres, which keeps her interesting, which keeps her, I don't want to say relevant, because she's always been relevant since Hannah Montana. I mean, come on, people. But she's just a mixed bag. With, like, say, Phil Collins, I have an idea of what I'm going to get. I'm going to get, you know, happy, dancey pop songs with a mix of a few ballads mixed in. And that's, each record is different from each other. I will give him that. But he doesn't change really complete genres with each album. I can, you know, I can listen to each album and sense that Phil Collins' sound. Miley does not have a defined sound whatsoever after Can't Be Tamed. Which is not a bad thing. It's just something I've noticed. Did you notice it too, or was it just me? I've got to go find Rainbow Land on this plastic contraption known as YouTube. So, let me know your thoughts in the comments, and I'll see you later. Bye, guys.